just like you, maker of heaven, Lord of the land, and Lord of the sea, holy and true, faithful and able, Lord of all time and eternity.
Hello there, friend. Every word that God speaks is alive and full of power to inform and transform, to make us what He desires us to be. The entrance of His word will give you light. Truth produces roots, and then the roots will produce fruit. God bless you. This message was preached by Dr. Ferdinand Nweke, coordinator of Eternity Ministries. We believe you will be edified. For the inquiries, contact Eternity Ministries, P.O. Box 2637, Bauchi, Nigeria, or telephone 0807-570-5411 or 0802-361-5940, or send us an email at eternitymin@yahoo.com. That is eternitymin@yahoo.com. Don't forget, the bigger God gets in your eyes, the tinier your mountains become.
Jesus, I want you to pray that the message I'm going to teach you this evening will be a blessing to your heart. It will produce enlargement for you. It will produce enlargement, an increase in your inner man, in the knowledge of God and of His power. The Bible says, moreover, the profit of the earth is for all. I want you to pray that you will begin to make profit in the place of prayer. Blessed be the name of Jesus Christ. Heavenly Father, we thank you for today. We pray, Almighty God, that beyond this teaching, your Holy Spirit will be here to implement the words that I teach in your name. In the name of Jesus Christ, I pray that the words will enter into the hearts of all that hear. I pray that the words will produce the purpose for which you send it forth, which is that your people will be mighty men and women in the arena of prayer. Blessed be your gracious name. In Jesus' almighty name we pray. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Okay. We have some things to study this evening. And like I said, blessed are your ears for some of the things you are going to hear today. I believe God is going to enlarge you and put some keys in your heart that will help you as you run your heavenly race. Amen. Ecclesiastes chapter 5, quickly, and verse 9. Let's all read together. One, two, go. You've not found it. Learn to turn your Bibles quick. Amen. Ecclesiastes chapter 5 and verse 9, 1, 2, go. Moreover, the profit of the earth is for all. The king himself is served by the field. In verse 8, let's read from verse 8, 1, 2, go. If thou seest the oppression of the poor, and violent perverting of judgment, and justice in a province, marvel not at the matter, for he that is higher than the highest regardeth, and thereby higher than they. Verse 9 said, what did he say in verse 9? Said, moreover, the profit of the earth is for how many people? Is for all. The king himself is served by the field. In that scripture, I want you to understand some things. The Bible says very clearly that if you see where oppression is going on, say you shouldn't worry. Don't be confused. Don't marvel. Don't be surprised. There is somebody that is higher than those people. And there's another person that Bible said is higher than the highest. That's Jesus. Amen and amen. He's higher. The Bible says he sees everything. So when you see oppression going on in Nigeria, the Bible says, don't be disturbed. Amen. There is somebody that is higher than the highest. Those that are in Aso Rock may think that they are the highest, but they are not. The Bible said, there is a person that is higher than the highest. And the Bible says he's watching what is going on. Then verse 9 makes a sentence I want to draw your attention to as we make progress this evening. He said, moreover, the profit of the earth is for all. Let me tell you something. There is enough in this planet. There is enough in the book. There is enough in the Bible for you to take your share. The profit of answered prayer is not for a few selected men of God inside the church. The prophet of faith that moves mountains is not for some great men and great evangelists and great general overseers. What did our Bible say? He said, moreover, I say, by the way, let me remind you, he said, the prophet of the earth is for how many people? It's for all. It's for every person that will decide to take their portion. That's what that scripture is saying. And as we are going to study prayer today, I want you to keep in mind that the profit of exploits in prayer is not for some people. It's for all. You see, even the king himself has to go and collect his own portion from where? From the field. And Bible said we are kings and priests unto God. There is a field, there is a virgin land. There are unoccupied highways of exploit in prayer. And Bible is saying today that the profit of the earth is for all. It's for everybody. The profit of praying and seeing God answer your prayers by terrible things in righteousness, the Bible said it is for all. The profit of speaking in the name of Jesus and seeing the commands you issue in the name of the Lord Jesus come to pass is not only for Joshua to talk to the sun and say, stop, stand down still at the valley of over Gibeon, and you moon, stand still at the valley of Aijalon. Bible said the moon stood still, the sun stood still for almost 24 hours for Joshua to avenge against the enemies of God. It's not only for Joshua. The Bible said the profit of the earth is for how many people? You know why I'm teaching you this? Because you need to understand that you are included in every promise that God has made in the Bible. Don't go and exclude yourself from some of the promises of God. Say, well, this one is for so and so person. Never, actually, it's for so and so. God should answer him when he prays like that. That's not the Bible pattern. The profit of the earth, the profit of answered prayer, the profit of praying and getting a tangible answer to your... You know, so many people in the church are strangers to answered prayer. They don't have a list of 5 things that they ask from God and they receive from God, and they knew that it was God that did it. Not coincidence. But there's a word from God today. He said the profit of the earth is for how many people? He says it's for all. But why do all not get it? Ecclesiastes chapter 10. We are studying prayer today. What it is and how it works. Ecclesiastes chapter 10. Amen. Just turn 2 pages on your Bible. Have you seen verse 15 now? Let's read 1-2, go everybody. The labor of the foolish does what? Wearieth every one of them. Why? Because he knoweth not how to go to the city. Does somebody have a simpler translation? Can you read for us? NIV or Living Bible? A fool's walk will weary him. It will tire him out without achieving his purpose. Yes? He does not know the road that leads to the town that he's going to. So what would he be doing? The energy that he had that would have taken him to where he was going, if he knew how to go there, what would he do? He will spend his time going round and round, wandering inside the bush, and he will not get to where he's going. Prayer is like that. When a man is not wise as to the principles that work in prayer, prayer will weary him. Are you understanding? The prayer people pray and get answer, he will pray it and get more confused. He will pray it and be wondering what's going on. How come I'm the only person here who don't get anything when I pray? That was not the plan of God. But the problem is that he does not know how to go to the city. And that is why we are studying the word of God, so that we can see what prayer is and how it works. Praise the name of Jesus. So that's what the word of God said. If you want to collect your own profit in this earth that you are living inside, you must know how to go to the city. Amen. You must know how to come to a place where you take your portion. The Bible says, God has made us meet to be partakers of the inheritance of the saints that are inside the light. Partaker means partakers. Takers of our part. That's what God has done. And we want to see how, by the grace of God, we can become takers of our part in the place of answered prayer. Amen? You remember this word? It's a Rehoboth. The Lord has made room for you, and we shall be fruitful in the land. In Genesis 26. I believe that God has made room for every born-again child of God in the place where exploits in prayer are carried out. But if you keep wearying you, you keep getting tired inside. You will keep surrendering instead of making progress and getting stronger and stronger and waxing bolder and praying more tremendous prayers. You'll be getting weaker and weaker because you don't know how to go to the city. It's not that going to the city is too difficult. Amen and amen. It's just that you didn't know the shortcut. You didn't know the straight road that goes to the place. Let me ask you, if we told you now to go to Gombe, and you did not know the road that goes to Gombe, what's going to happen? You are going to start, you will travel to Jos, then from Jos you go to Kaduna, from Kaduna you go to Kano, from Kano you go to Maiduguri, from Maiduguri you come down to Biu, and then from Biu you are going to come down now back to Gombe. If they ask you to travel to Gombe next week, are you likely to agree to travel? No, but you see, because you will be angry. You will remember all the things you went through when you are going to Gombe last time. But the problem is not in going to Gombe. The problem was that you did not know the simple, straight, tarred, beautiful road that leads to Gombe. If you did, you just take your drive, you are there. If they say, come back tomorrow, you go. When you don't understand how prayer works, prayer will weary you. The more you pray, the more confused you get. The more you pray, the more desperate you become. Because you didn't know the road to the city. But when you know the road... When you know, those of you who are computer students here, if in the computer center, some people who don't know how to find what they are looking for, how to call up the fire they are looking for, what's going to happen? They are going to sit on that table for how many hours? 7-8 hours doing nothing. And they'll be wondering, what is this on this screen? They will press enter on this one. It will do... They say, what's going on in this place? And as far as they are concerned, computer is impossible. But those that know how to go to the city, those that know how to select the particular file that they are looking for, they just come and press Alt something and press the Enter. Boop, windows will appear on top. That's how prayer is. When you know how prayer works and what it is, you realize that you can pray without sweatlessly. Pastor Kumi told a story that blessed my heart. He said they brought one madman. He said the man was held by 4 people. They brought the man. The man was struggling with them, pushing there. And they brought the man to his office. And by the time they brought the man to him, he was on his way out. In fact, he was about to enter into the car. He said, oh, pastor, please, what can he do for them? So he said, the glass of the window. And he looked at the man and said, "Oh, all of you, leave him." He said, "Pastor, leave him." He said, "Leave him." They left the man. "It's okay, you are well now in the name of Jesus Christ." The man's eyes clear like this. The man became sane. Began to wonder, say, "Where am I? What's happening to me?" They come and say, "If you can take him now, you can go." He wound up his glass. If that's not true, he's waiting for to pray tomorrow. You want to pray, but is it because he didn't know? One woman met him on the tarmac in the airport in Rome. He was traveling. She was traveling. They were changing plane. And this woman has been trying to see Pastor Kumuyi, and she can't see. She's not been able to meet him. And so as they were carrying their bag, going on the tarmac, she said, "Oh, excuse me, I think you're Pastor Kumuyi." He said, "Yes, yes." "Oh, I've been trying to see you." He said, "Okay, yes, you're seeing me now." He said, in fact, we have been married for so years. We don't have any child." He said, "Okay, yes, yes. So what do you want now?" He said, "Please, Pastor, can you pray on the tarmac in the airport?" He turned. He said, "Okay, let us pray here now." He said, "Jesus, please give her a baby. Amen." You must say, "Amen." And she went, and he went. About 1 year later, one woman was carrying a baby boy. I said, Pastor, don't you remember me?" He said, "No, I can't remember you. I see so many people." "I see so many people. Who are you?" He said, "I'm that woman in the airport in Rome." The woman said, okay. The woman said, "And this is the baby you told Jesus to give to me." If that's how prayer is, would you want to pray tomorrow? You want to pray, you see, but because we didn't know the road to go to the city, it looks so impossible. It looks so impossible. I pray you will find out in the name of Jesus Christ. What is prayer? Prayer is the heart's communion with its maker. Prayer is man's communion, the sum total of man's relationship and communion with his maker. That's prayer. At the place of prayer, man is able to greet his maker. Man is able to get to the person that manufactured him in the first place. At prayer, man has access to the source from where he came out. At the place of prayer, that is where man meets his maker. That's where man stands before the one that manufactured him. That is where man makes a face-to-face communion with his maker, at the place of prayer. It is at the point of prayer that man jams the one that manufactured him. And if you understand what that means, you will understand that prayer is the place where everything is possible. Job chapter 35. By reason of the multitude of oppressions, what happens? They make the oppressed to do what? To cry. They cry out by reason of the arm of the mighty. I want you to understand well. Can we all read together? I want to go from verse 9. By reason of the multitude of oppressions, they make the oppressed to do what? To cry. They cry out, how? By reason of the arm of the mighty. Now read verse 10 very carefully. What does verse 10 say? He said, "But none said, where is God my maker, who giveth songs in the night?" Verse 11 said, "Who teacheth us more than the beasts of the earth, and maketh us wiser than the fowls of heaven?" Verse 12 said, "Dear they cry, but what happens? None giveth answer." Why? Because of the pride of evil men. Verse 13 said, surely God will not hear vanity. That text is talking about prayer. God will not listen to vanity. Neither will the Almighty regard it. Look up at me here. Let me explain that scripture. You need to understand that scripture. What is verse 9 saying? Verse 9 said, by reason of the multitude of oppressions, what do they do? Eh? He said they make the oppressed to cry out. So the oppressed will be crying, yeah, wah, wah, yeah, and they'll be screaming and crying. Bible now said, he said they cry out by reason of the arm of the mighty. What is going on? The arm of the mighty is oppressing who? The oppressed. Is that what that scripture is saying? Yes. And so the oppressed are crying, hey, oh, yeah, oh, oh, these mighty people, see what they need to me, see what they need to my father, see what they need to my health, see what they need to my body, see what they need to my stomach, oh, see what they need to my soul, oh, oh. And the oppressed are crying. By reason of the arm, the oppression of the mighty. Verse 10 gives you what I'm talking about. He said, why are they doing all this crying and making all this noise? He said, none of them say yet, where is God my maker? You see, they are crying. They are looking for deliverance. They are trying to get a way out. But in the midst of all their crying is wearying them. Their crying, their prayers, their tears are bringing more pain inside their heart. And there's no way out. Why? Verse 10 said, God, in the midst of all this, they are crying, way, woo, hey, the oppressed, oh, the mighty, see my health, see my stomach, look at my exams, see my family, see my health, see my soul, see my finances, see my pocket. Why they are doing all that? Bible said, none of them has come to a point where he says, excuse me, please, where is God my maker? Where is the God that manufactured me in the first place? Who should be able, by his power, to intervene and undertake for me? The Bible said they are doing all their crying, raising their tears, pouring out their hearts. I said, oh, look at these mighty people. See how this terrible devil is harassing me. See how this one is adding to me. See what is going on. Bible said, none of them, in the midst of that their prayer meeting, if it's a prayer meeting, none of them said, excuse me, brethren. Why don't we go back to God, our maker? Blessed be the name. Why is he telling you that? Because he knows that if they only ask that question, they will eventually end up in the presence of God, their maker, who giveth songs in the night. I pray you get understanding. You need to understand. Prayer is the place where a man and a woman come in direct contact with their maker. And in that place, anything is possible. From sorting out the present man that God has manufactured to manufacturing a brand new one. See these people. Bible said the oppressed are crying out. Oh, brother, let me tell you something. Don't joke. Their oppression is terrible. Those that are oppressing them, how are they? Their hand, Bible calls it the hand of the mighty. They are in real trouble. But why they are inside the depths of their trouble? Bible said, none of them had enough understanding. None of them got enough revelation to know that if they can get back to their maker. So look, my friend, once upon a time, there was nothing called ID. So, the person that, imagine now that we have a sharp player, or this keyboard now from Yamaha, and all, did they have some problems, and everybody has tried to fiddle it, they press this one, all the electronic engineers in this place, they change this one, change this IC, put this, connected the plug, remove this, lose it, and they have done that for 2 weeks. But there's Yamaha in town. That's a Yamaha workshop. While they are doing that, I'm trying to sort out this mighty problem that has entered into this Yamaha keyboard. None of them bothered to remember the Yamaha workshop from which this keyboard came out. The Bible said, none sayeth, where is God, my maker, that giveth songs in the night? If any of them asked that question, what do you think will have happened? He will have come to the place of prayer. And when he meets the maker, did you see the name the Bible calls him? That giveth songs. Where? In the middle of the night. Hallelujah. Give Jesus a clap of him. Give Jesus a clap of him. Prayer is the place. It's all right now. Prayer is the place where man meets his maker that giveth songs in the night. If you don't have a song in the middle of your night, you have never met your maker. You didn't meet your maker. Because if you met him, whatever was closing your mouth from singing will be taken away. Can I get an amen to that? Whatever was your oppression of the mighty will be taken away. Let me show you one scripture. Now, before we go to that, let's finish with this one. Bible said, hallelujah, blessed be the glory. Bible said, who giveth songs in the night? In the middle of the night. He said, if I can get to my maker, he's going to put a new song. Have you forgotten that scripture? He said, he took my feet from the miry clay and set them upon the solid rock to stay. And he put a song in my mouth, a song of praise. Hallelujah. 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 Now shall my head be lifted up above my adversaries. What the Bible says. The Lord my God, my strength, my song, has now become my victory. The Lord is God, and I will praise him, my father's God, and I will exalt. You see, he says, if you study the Bible carefully, you will notice something. Bible talks about strength, song, salvation. Strength, the Lord is my strength. He also has become my salvation. The strength of God, the song he puts in your mouth, and the deliverance that he brings with it. Amen and amen. Nobody has that. Nobody bothered to ask, where is God my maker? People go through difficult things today. I was preaching in a full gospel meeting. And I preached on God's intervention. The ability of Almighty God to intervene in the affairs of men. What the Almighty finger of God can do when it is interposed in the situations and circumstances of men and nations. And after preaching, the program was already about to end. And one man came out. The full gospel leaders were already about to close the meeting. We are about to sing his banner over us, his Lord. And the man came out and said, excuse me. He was carrying a bag. He was carrying a bag. And he just came forward and said, excuse me, please. I want to say something. Huh? The leader looked at me. I said, okay. He's around out there. The man was not a member of the fellowship. He just came. I think somebody invited him. I said, okay. I said, allow him. Let him say something. Let him give a testimony. Then the man took the microphone. He said, nobody ever told him that God could help somebody that he never knew. That after he graduated and he from his loss, he got a law diploma, he tried to find a job, he couldn't get a job, then he began to go from Babalawo to Babalawo. And the man opened his bag and began to bring out charms that were given to him by people that he went to look for answer from. And eventually, those charms, they look terrible. We burned them in front of Zaranda Hotel that day. You need to see the thick smoke, horrible smell that was coming out of it. What the man was carrying in his bag. When you see people carrying bag on the road, you don't know what they're carrying. Let me tell you the truth. How did he end up in that condition? Because the man never could say, where is God that brought me into this world? That is the place of prayer. Where men jam the God that giveth songs in the night. Amos calls him, he said, seek ye him that maketh the seven stars, the Pleiades and the Orion, that turneth the night into the morning. Listen to me. That is the place of prayer. And Bible said, in verse 11, he said, who teacheth us more than the beasts of the earth? If they had called on God their maker, what would have happened? He would have revealed to them the way of escape. The Bible said, the snare is broken. And what has happened? And we have escaped. See, our soul has escaped out of the snare of the fowlers. Our help is in the name of the Lord, who manufactured the heavens and the earth. You get it now? Are you understanding now? He said, this God our maker teaches us. The next part said, and maketh us wiser than the fowls of the heaven. Do you understand that scripture? Bible said, and thou, Timothy, from a youth, thou hast known the holy scriptures, which are able to do what? To make thee wise. Unto what? Unto salvation. Unto deliverance from the mighty. Unto liberty. Prayer is the place where men meet with their maker. Where men meet with the one that gave them existence in the first place. The one whose almighty finger brought them into the world, and whose almighty finger can sort them out inside the world. That's the place of prayer. Chapter 12, verse 16. Job. We are still in Job. 12, 16. You know, they were crying by reason of the oppression of the oppressors. Is that not correct? And by reason of the arm of the mighty. Let me show you something in verse chapter 12 of Job. Verse 16. Can we go 1, 2, everybody? From verse 16 down. 1, 2, go. With him is strength and wisdom. The deceived and the deceiver, they belong to him together. Who is that? That is God, my maker. At the place of prayer, you meet the God that owns both the deceived and the deceiver. You meet the person that owns the oppressed and the oppressor. You meet the person that owns the harassed and the harasser. I pray you will get understanding. I pray you will get understanding. Prayer is the place where you come before the ultimate judge of the universe. The owner of the harassed and the harasser. If you win your case in that court, you will get songs in the night. You see the way it works? That's the place of prayer. He said the oppressed and the oppressor. Who owns the two of them? God, my maker. The deceived and the deceiver. Who owns the two of them? God, my maker. Let's keep reading. See what he can do to kings in that place. And the mighty. He leadeth counselors away. What? Spoil. And maketh the judges. What? Fools. You will see what happened now to the what judge? That unrighteous judge that Jesus talked about. You see what happened to him? I will explain to you. So the Bible said in verse 18, he looseth the bond of kings and girdeth their loins with a girdle. 19 said, he leadeth princes away, spoiled, and those want to the mighty and overthrew it the mighty. You didn't understand. If you understood, you'll be clapping by now. You'll be shouting by now. He said he led it away. Princes, what? Spoil. What does he do to this mighty? By reason of whose oppression, the oppressed are crying out in chapter 35. Bible said he overthrew it the mighty. You see, they were crying, oh, oppressed, yeah, this might. mighty people that harass me. This is my mighty problem. This is my mighty situation. This is my impossible sickness. Oh, this is my cancer. Hey, this is my barrenness. Hey, my pocket, there is no money inside. Hey, devil is harassing my children. Hey, my family, my family. All the mighty, mighty problems that we are having. Did you see what the Bible said? He said, none of them say it. Where is God, my maker? But none asketh, where is God, my maker? That giveth songs in the night, that overthroweth the mighty. Let me tell you, prayer is the place where the oppressed meet the person, the one and only person that can overthrow the mighty. Amen and amen and amen. Hallelujah. Hannah said he has pulled, Mary said he has pulled down the mighty from their seats. He has exalted the humble. That's the place of prayer. Prayer is the place where men meet with their maker. Proverbs 22. Proverbs 22 and verse 2. They turn in your Bible. Oh, blessed be the name. Proverbs 22 and verse 2. Can we all read together? One, two, go. One more time. The rich and the poor meet together. The Lord is the maker of them. Oh. Is that NIV you are reading? Read it. Say they have one thing in common. Yes, read.
Rich and poor have this in common. The Lord is the maker of them all.
Did you hear that scripture? What does that scripture say? He said, you see the rich? They say, yes, we can see the rich. Oh, the rich are mighty. Look at how big and how high and how terrible they are. They are just walking majestically and just going as if they are untouchable. Bible said, look at the poor. Just poor riffraff. Just going, going, going. NIV said, two of them, there is something they have in common. There is a factor by which you can divide the two of them. He said, the rich and the poor, they meet together. There's a place. More like this, it's your blessed be the glory of God. Bible said there's a place where the rich and the poor, where they must stand. Bible said there is a place where the rich must meet with the poor. It will not be optional when they get to that place. It's not whether they like it or not. The Bible said there is something rich people have in common with the poor. What did he say? He said the Lord is the manufacturer of the two of them. So if the poor has been trying to get an appointment with the rich and the thing is not working out, and the poor has been trying to get judgment against the rich, and the rich is using the rich as the rich always do. You know, rich people use the rich to oppress the poor. Are you aware of that? They help themselves in their game of oppression. If the poor, we go to that meeting point. If the poor can get to that junction. Oh God. People, there is a junction where the rich and the poor, they must jam. There is a junction where the oppressed and the oppressor must jam. There is a place where the harassed and the harasser must all stand together in the same uniform to hear the counsel of the one that manufactured the two of them. That is prayer. Prayer bypasses all the other express roads. The rich are going like this, fiam. And the poor are going like this, boom, 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 in their kunkuru, boom, boom, boom. And these are going, fiam, fiam. Prayer will not attempt to stop the rich and the mighty along that express road. You know what prayer will do? The rich will go, fiam, and pass the poor. The poor will say, he that is down, if you are do for. And just be calling like that. And the rich and the mighty and the oppressor, they will be oppressing the poor. But you now understand what the Bible said in the book of Psalm. He said, poor man cried. And what happened? And the Lord answered. If a poor man has no business trying to stop the rich on the express road, no. What does Bible say he should do? He should report to the place where the two of them must meet together. The presence of Almighty God. The presence of Almighty God. When I begin to talk about how prayer works, you will understand what I'm saying. Clearly. There's a place they meet together. You and the person causing your problem. There's a place two of you meet together. It's at the throne of grace. It's in the presence of the maker. Bible said the deceived and the deceiver. What happened? They belong to the same person. That's what prayer is. Prayer is man's channel to Almighty God. Prayer is man's channel. The pipe that connects man to the almightiness of God. Job 23. Job is a favorite book of mine. And there are some terrific truths inside that place. Job 23. Turn your Bible quickly. And let's read from verse 3. Well, from verse 1. Can we read together? 1, 2, everybody now go. Then Job answered and said, even today is my complaint bitter. My stroke is heavier than my groaning. I don't know if you understand that. Job is saying, the groaning that I am groaning does not really, really reflect the degree of my stroke. It's terrible. When your tears are not manifesting the real grief, it must be a very terrible situation. Then Job began to let out a prayer. Have you seen verse 3? Oh, that I knew where I might find it. When you read that word, oh, in the Bible, don't jump. It tells you the state of heart of the man that is making the prayer. In Isaiah 64 verse 1, you know what Isaiah cried? Isaiah said, oh, that thou wouldest rend the heaven and come down. 1 Chronicles chapter 4 verse 9 and 10. Do you know what Jabez cried out? Oh, that thou wouldest bless me indeed. That oh, it showed you the overflow of the pain inside the heart of Mr. Jabez. In Isaiah 48, after God looked at Israel and all the things they suffered because of their disobedience, God was pained in his heart. God said, oh, that my people had listened to my voice. How I wish these people had listened to me. Oh, Psalm 81, he said, oh, that you have hearkened to me. Then your peace will have been like a river and your righteousness like the flowing brooks of the sea. Oh, so that two letter word tells us the state of the heart of Job when he was raising that cry. Job said, oh, that I knew where I might find it. How I wish I knew where I can find it. By the grace of God, by the revelation of the Holy Ghost, today's born-again child of God knows where he can find him. Amen and amen and amen. Amen and amen. Job said, oh, I knew where I can find him. I wish that I can only, if only I knew a place that I can meet with him. Then Job said, what would he have done when he got there? Look at Isaiah. That I might come to his seat. Job said, if only I knew the road that I can pass, and I would be standing before him like this. What did Hebrews 4 say? He said, therefore, you can come boldly unto the seat of grace. Job said, oh, oh. Verse 4. Job said, when I have found him, and when I have gotten right into his presence, What's going to happen? I will order my course before him, and I will fill my mouth with argument. Joseph, if I knew where I could find this God, my maker, when I get to his chair, to his seat, I know what I'm going to do. You see, I will order my course before him. I will set my case in order. He said, I will fill my mouth with argument. Isaiah 43, he said, plead your case. Bring forth your strong reasons that you might plead together. Prayer is a place where you can find God. It's a place where you can plead your cause. It's a place where you can fill your mouth with arguments, scriptural arguments on why your prayer must be answered. Do you know? At the place of prayer, you can fill your mouth with argument. One of those arguments will be Romans chapter 8 verse 32. He said, he that did not spare his only begotten son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not with him freely give us all things? If you knew where you can find God, and you knew his chair, when you get to that place, you say, excuse me, Papa, are you not the one that said that what things shall I desire, when I pray, I should believe I will receive them? Eh? You say, yes, I said that. You said that? You said that? You say, yeah, I said that. Are you not the one that said that you gave your son to Jesus Christ to me freely? That there's nothing you will ever withhold from me? If you gave your son, Papa, if you gave your son Jesus to me free of charge, can you explain to me why you will not give me 3,000 naira that I need for my school fees? Now, in the name of Jesus, he said, I will order my cause. I will set out my case. I will plead my matter. I will fill my mouth with argument. I will argue my case. Mr. Moses knew where to find him. And when he found him, God said, Moses, let me alone. Let me wipe them out. Moses said, excuse me, please. Wait more. Should they tell you something? Go. Can I talk? He said, yes, you can talk. Say, excuse me. If you wipe them out now, you know what these Egyptians are going to say? They will say that it was because you were a very weak person. You could not take them inside that place. So when you came outside here, you tried to make excuses and just wiped all of them out. Then we say, how about that, sir? Did you think about that? Then he said, excuse me. Now, what about those covenants you made with their papa, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob? What's going to happen to those ones? Papa, are you hearing what I'm saying? God said, yes, yes. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Say, yeah. And by the way, the Egyptians are going to hear. And they are going to laugh. God said, nobody should be laughing at my name like that. Okay, Moses, I agree with what you're saying. He said, Job said, if I knew where I can find him, I will fill my mouth. If a barren woman knew where she can find him, born again child of God, you know where you are going to find him. You get to that place, you don't know what you are going to say. The Syrophoenician woman knew where to find him. The woman traveled from her coasts. And Bible said, Jesus was also in the same coasts of Tyre and Sidon. And the woman said, great! I don't catch you today. I found you. Lord, have mercy on me. Lord, have mercy on me. You know, Jesus was terrified. But she began to shout from afar so that he will not disappear. So that he will not branch anywhere. Lord, have mercy. Lord, Lord. Jesus turned and kept on going. Lord, 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 have mercy on me. He said, Bible said he answered her not a word. Kept quiet, I was going. You see, you are the one. Before I found you, that was when I had a problem. Before I got to your chair, that was when I had a problem. But today, hallelujah, hallelujah. I'm sure the woman danced more, that's well. I don't find it today. Jesus didn't talk. He said, The woman came there and said, Oga, help me. And he said, I am not sent, but only to the lordship of the house of Israel. He said, okay. Hey, is it like that? He said, okay. Please just help me. Then they send that away, send that away. He said, send me away. To the day that I have come to his seat, you send me away? You are joking. And Jesus said, hey, look, mother, it's not correct to take what belongs to the children and give to the dogs. She said, you are very correct, sir. But excuse me, is it not correct that the dogs under the table can also chop the crumbs that fall down from the master's table? The book of Mark says something that I like. When that woman made that sentence in the book of Mark, you know what Jesus said? Jesus said, for this that he said, because of this thing you said, go, it is well, your daughter is well, just go. He said, I will order my cause before him and fill my mouth with arguments. Verse 5 said, I will know the words which he would answer me and understand what he will say unto me. You see, all the several types of prayers are mentioned in that scripture. Job say, I will hear what he has to tell me, just like Habakkuk. Say, I will stand upon my watch and I will hear what God has to say to me. Amen. Look at verse 6. He said, will he plead against me with his great power? When I get to his seat, is he going to terrify me with his majesty? Is he going to do war and destroy me? Can somebody read another version? Read NIV. He said, when I get to that place, is he going to harass me with his majesty? Will he use his almightiness to harass me simply because I'm arguing my case and pleading my cause in his presence? Job said, no! No, man, no! Will he condemn me and keep on condemning me in my sins? No! Will he condemn me because of my unbeliefs and cast me out of his presence? No! Can I tell you something tonight? The word of God and prayer are the two scriptural solutions to unbelief. If you pray, you will get faith. Several times, if you will but pray, God will answer your prayer. The mark of unbelief is that unbelief will not come to the throne of grace. Once you come to that chair, they put faith into your account. They say, this man believed. If he didn't believe, he wouldn't have come here. Job said, would he harass and terrify me and terrorize me with his majesty and with his holiness? He said, no, he will put strength. Amen. Amen. He will put strength into me. Verse 7 is a wonder. Oh, verse 7 is a wonder. He said, there the righteous might dispute with him. So should I be delivered forever from my judge. Blessed be the name of Jesus Christ. Job said, dear, at the place of prayer, at the place at his presence, at that throne of grace, he said, dear, the righteous might dispute with him, and I will be delivered forever from my oppressors. He said, dear, brother, there's deliverance for you. There's help for you. But the problem is that it is there, that I knew where I might find him. There, the righteous might dispute with him. There, in his presence, you can order your course aright. You can fill your mouth with arguments. The strength that you are lacking. You can now understand Isaiah 40:31. He said, they that wait upon the Lord, they shall mount up, they shall renew. They shall renew their what? Their strength. Where did they get it from? There, the righteous might dispute with him. He will put strength within me. Prayer is the place of strength. It's the place where the rich and the poor, they meet together.
where the harassed and the harasser, where they jam together before the Almighty One that can sort both of them out. Blessed be the name of Jesus Christ. Prayer is your avenue for a miracle. I can't talk enough about this one. Where did Jabez get his own miracle? There will I be delivered forever from my judge. Where was Hannah delivered from the oppressions of Penina? There. How was Peter delivered from the oppressions of Mr. Herod? There. How was Paul and Silas delivered in the middle of the night from the dungeons of the Philippians? There. How will Nigeria be delivered from the fingers of the sons and daughters of the bondman? Amen. 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 In the name of Jesus Christ. How will the souls of multitudes that are in Islam be delivered? How are the barren delivered from their barrenness? Will I be delivered forever? Forever, forever. The reason people do not get a permanent deliverance is because they are collecting it from men of God. Say, in the name of Jesus. In the name of, they didn't go there. The blind will be delivered from their blindness forever. The sick will be delivered from their sickness forever. A permanent deliverance. Prayer is that place. Say, dear. That's why the Bible says, is any among you afflicted? Let him report, dear. How will your relations that are not born again, how will they be delivered from the clutches of sin and the devil? The righteous might dispute with him. You can fill your mouth with arguments for your relations that are not born again. You say, Papa, did you not say in your Bible that I should ask and receive that my joy may be full? They say, yes, we said that. They say, Papa, do you expect my joy to be full when my mother and my brothers are at the gate of hell? They say, really, Ferdinand, no. I say, okay, what are we going to do about it now, sir? They say, dear. If you didn't get what you are looking for, you didn't go there. That's prayer. Prayer, that's the place. Your avenue, your express route to a miracle. That's prayer. Even Mr. Samson, with his eyes plugged out, with his head shaved, but growing gradually, Samson reported there, and he prayed a prayer. He said, Oh God, hear me. Did he terrify Samson with his great power when he reported there? Did he say, Mr. Samson, you would have been going around with the hellos. What are you doing in my presence? No! Because he knew that the day Samson decided to report to that place, he had decided to repent from his iniquities. Yeah, Samson, look at you, judge of Israel. I sent you to come and do ministry in the land of Israel, and you allowed them to pluck out your eyes. What are you calling my name for? Did you do that? No! Some people think that sin can lock them out of the place of prayer. Whereas if they decide to come to that place of prayer, it will also solve the sin problem that is inside their life. What is prayer? Prayer is your hotline to heaven. Isaiah 58. Verse 4. Isaiah 58 and verse 4. Can we all read together? One, two, go. Behold, ye fast for strife and debate and to smite with the feast of wickedness. Ye shall not fast as ye do this day to make your voice to be heard on high. God was correcting them. God said, no. This way you are fasting, that is not the correct way to fast. If you want your voice to be heard where? On high. Smith Wigglesworth said, God does not answer prayers that are circulating on the earth. You see, that your prayer has to burn through the heavens. Amen. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah! Your voice can be heard on high. I said your voice can be heard on high. And can I tell you something? Remember Ecclesiastes chapter 5 verse 8? He said there is somebody that is higher than the highest. When your voice is heard on high, what is going to happen below? You have to line up. That's why Bible calls God the Most High. Brother, at the place of prayer, your voice can be heard on high. Your voice can be heard in the highest quarters, in the highest council of the universe, in the highest governing council. Amen. You know the Nigerian governing council is called provisional. You know what provisional mean? Meanwhile governing council. The governing council that is in charge, meanwhile. Amen. All the governing councils of earth, they are all provisional. Professor, university governing council, does it stay forever? No, they are provisional. They stay for a particular term. They pack out. Amen. Soldier come, soldier go. Amen and amen and amen. Amen and amen. For the Most High abided forever and ever. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty God. When you get to the place of the Most High, you will start abiding in the almightiness of God. When your voice is heard on high, the almightiness of God begins to walk on your behalf. And you know what the Bible said? The Bible said in the book of Job, he said, when he giveth quietness, who then can make trouble? Job 34. See, when God giveth quietness, who the hell can make trouble? In Romans chapter 8, something like that is written. He said, it is God that justifieth. Who the hell is it that will condemn us? Prayer is the God-ordained ladder between heaven and earth. Hallelujah. John chapter 1. John chapter 1. When Nathanael came to Jesus, the Bible said, Jesus, in verse 48, I said unto him, where is Noah's army? Jesus answered unto him, before that Philip called thee, when thou was under the fig tree, I saw thee. I was watching you. Not. You know, when Nati was coming, Jesus said, behold an Israelite in whom there is no God. Nat said, excuse me, sir, where did you know me? He said, you? You don't know who you are talking to. I think that's your problem. He's asking his maker, where did he know him? I don't know if you understand what I'm talking about. He's asking his maker. It's like this keyboard will go and ask Yamaha, Yamaha, where did you know me? Where did you know me? Is that you? Is that right? Why you are sitting under the fig tree? I saw you before Philip came and called you. I said, hey, master, you are the Christ, the Son of God. You are the Son of David. You are the King of Israel. In verse 50, Jesus answered and said unto him, because I said unto thee, I saw thee under the fig tree, believest thou? Believest thou? Thou shalt see greater things than this. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hear me well tonight. You shall see greater things in your Christian life. In the name of Jesus Christ. You shall see greater things in the ministry God called you to. In the name of Jesus Christ. You are going to see greater answers to your prayers. In the name of Jesus Christ. You are going to see greater manifestations of the power of God. In the name of Jesus Christ. You are going to see greater miracles in your life. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thou shalt see greater things than this. Can I hear you say, I shall see greater things than this. I shall see greater things than this. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thou shalt see greater things than this. Whatever you have seen now in your Christian life, my friend, thou shalt see greater things than this in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. 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 The Bible said in verse 51, and he said unto him, verily, Living Bible said, with all the earnestness I possess, verily, verily, I say unto you, from now on, after this my meeting with you, Nat, after this prayer meeting tonight, after this teaching tonight, hereafter, ye shall see heaven open and the angels of God ascending and descending upon the Son of Man. Genesis chapter 28. Hallelujah. Turn your Bible quickly. Genesis 28. Prayer is your express road to greater things. If you are tired of where you are, begin to pray. If you are tired of reading the Bible and not seeing any answers to your prayers, begin to pray. If you are tired of being powerless in your Christian life and you are looking for greater things, begin to pray. If you are tired of being harassed by men and pushed around and kicked by juniors, begin to pray. If you are tired of staying on this mountain at this particular level where you have been for 20 years, begin to pray. Genesis 28. You know the story from verse 10. And Jacob went out from Beersheba and went toward Haran. Verse 11, 28, Genesis. And he lighted upon a certain place and tarried there all night because the sun was set. And he took up the stones of that place and put them for his pillows and lay down in that place to sleep. You got to learn how to take stones from the word of God for your pillow and rest your weary head. Rest your tired head on the promises of heaven. Verse 12 said, and he dreamed, and behold, what was Jacob going to see? A ladder set up on the earth, and the top of it reached into where? Into heaven. Look up here. A ladder set up on the earth, and the top of it reached into heaven. A ladder set up on the earth, and the top reached. Everybody say reached. Reached. The top reached there. It reached to headquarters. It reached. That's why in Hebrews chapter 6, Bible said, which hope we have as an anchor of the soul, both sure and steadfast, that entereth in into the veil, where Christ our forerunner has gone for us, having been made a priest forever after the order of Melchizedek. Bible said the top, the ladder was set up on the earth. Oh, hallelujah. But the top reached into heaven. The top of this ladder, which is based on planet earth, the top enters into the treasure houses of heaven. He said the top reached, he reached. The thing didn't stop in the middle of the air. If you are climbing this ladder, there is no question about whether you are going to reach or you are not going to reach. Because the Bible said the top did what? It reached into heaven. And what did Joseph, Jacob say? He saw what Jesus was telling Philip about. And behold, the angels of God ascending and descending on it. 13. And behold, the Lord stood above it. And God spoke, I am the Lord God of Abraham, thy father, the God of Isaac, the land whereon thou liest, to thee will I give it, and to thy seed. Jump down to verse 16. And Jacob awaked out of his sleep, and he said, surely the Lord is in this place, and I knew it not. And he was afraid, and said, how dreadful is this place? This is none other but the house of God, and this is the gate of heaven. Jesus told Nathanael, you are going to see the angels. You are going to see heaven open. And the ladder standing from earth to heaven, and angels ascending and descending upon the Son of Man. I try to understand that scripture. Bible said angels ascending and descending upon. What does upon mean? On top of the Son of Man. When they are climbing, what are they climbing on top? The Son of Man. When they are coming down, what are they coming down upon? The Son of Man. Prayer climbs the ladder of the Son of Man to get to an otherwise unreachable heaven. Prayer is the ladder you can climb. The ladder upheld and sustained by the Son of Man. Jesus is the ladder that connects earth to heaven. He is the staircase that connects barren earth to abundant heaven. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of Jesus Christ. And at the place of prayer, you climb that ladder. What is prayer? Prayer is man's defense from his worst enemy. That's the devil. Prayer is your defense against the wicked and crooked devil in this terminal generation. Prayer is your defense. When we talk about how prayer works, you'll be understanding that. Prayer is your defense. Why do I say that? Because the deceived and the deceiver, they belong to him. So when you take the two of them and report them to their maker, what's going to happen? You will get deliverance. He said, dear, will I be delivered forever from my judge? Prayer is your ticket to unending joy. Amen and amen. Amen and amen and amen. Prayer is your ticket to unending joy. John chapter 16, we'll close up our message there this evening. John 16. What is prayer? There will I be delivered forever from my charge. John 16, from verse 23. Can we read? One, two, go. Loud. And in that day ye shall ask me nothing. Verily, verily, I say unto you, whatsoever ye shall ask the Father in my name, he will give it you. 24. Everybody want to go? Hitherto have ye asked nothing in my name. Ask, and they shall receive, that your joy may be full. Amplified said, but now, ask and keep on asking, and you will receive, so that your joy, your gladness, your delight may be full and complete. Prayer is that place. When you get there, your sorrow will be turned to joy. Can I get an amen to that? Yeah. When you get there, your pain will be turned to pleasure. Your harassment will be turned to happiness. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, he said, ask and you will receive. So that what is going to happen? Your joy, your gladness, your delight, your joy. Can I tell you something tonight, friends? Too many Christians are too dry. The Bible calls it the oil of joy for the spirit of what? Heaviness. Joy is the oil that lubricates the Christian's engine. When a child of God does not have joy, he will knock. Those of you that drive, you understand what I'm talking about. The engine will knock. Will yak, bah, 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 bah. The piston and everything will scatter. The Bible calls it the oil of joy. Where do they get it from? He said, yeah. When you ask and you receive your joy. Bible says, when the Lord turned again the captivity of Zion, what happened? Say, we are like those that dream. He said, then was our mouth filled with laughter. Laughter. Do you laugh? Born again, child of God. Several of you don't know how to laugh. Several of you don't know. Say, Brother Hannah, fine.
You don't laugh. But a child of God should be a specimen of joy. You see, because he has no body. He's not carrying any load. Amen. He has reported to that place and offloaded. Beer, they say, that beer is a place where you can offload your bodies. What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. And oh, what peace we often forfeit. And oh, what needless pains we bear. Oh, because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. Do thy friends despise, forsake thee? Take it to the Lord in prayer. With his hands in his arms, he'll take and shield thee. Thou wilt find a soul is there. It's a place where you find your solace. It's a place where you find your rest. It's a place where your bodies are taken away. Cast upon the Most High that cared for you. If you don't report there, there'll be no oil in your lamp. If you don't report there, there'll be no rest in your heart. If you don't report there, Bible said, be careful for nothing. What does nothing mean? Zero. He said, but in everything, let with prayers and supplications, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known unto God. And what's going to happen? And as an inevitable consequence, the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, what's going to happen? You will keep. Everybody say keep. You will keep your heart and your mind inside Christ Jesus. What if there are troubles and turmoils all around? You will keep. You will stand garrison. That's how the Amplified puts it. You will mount a garrison over your heart and your mind. If you don't report there, How can you live? Too many believers, when you see them going with their faces like that, it's not because they are carrying anything. It's because they didn't go there. Bible said, there. Brother, and you know me and you, we have no right to be saying, oh, that I know where I might find him. If you say that now, you are a hypocrite. You know where you can find him. At the throne of grace. The Bible said, there. Blessed be the name of Jesus Christ. Let us pray together. Let's pray. Mitonatos terenika Messiah. Everybody got to pray. Everybody got to pray. Dotarana sunta madana so tayandre nito playa. Gitoronde la Messiah. Topos imasola maranata kaya. There. The righteous might dispute with it.